Hello everyone. I know many of us have been searching for the most genuine free energy device, and we've settled for Noman Shah Afridi's device. And many of us have been wondering what really is behind his free energy device, which incidentally happens to be a modified version of Charles Campbell's original design. And some of us have even watched Mr. Afridi's video over and over again, and we still can't get the clues we want. So I decided I should make this video to share some of the secrets that people should know about if they plan on replicating his device. Point number one, use gears. If you're able to build one into the system, or use a belt tension adjuster to slowly drive the flywheel from rest to over unity. It's important to note that if your drive motor is able to spin the flywheel from rest even without a gear or a belt tension adjuster, then the motor is only putting a fraction of its energy into the flywheel. Hence, the system will not operate at over unity. This is central to the overall success of the system. Overload the system with energy, and it just can't handle it. I would suggest you consider modifying the drive pulleys by making it larger or making the flywheel heavier to achieve the desired effect. Point number two, a low RPM permanent magnet alternator is your best bet. Otherwise, you have a hard time getting the system to operate at the speed required by most AC synchronous generators. Standard alternators require speeds of about 1500 RPMs or thereabout to even remotely begin generating power. Permanent magnet alternators, on the other hand, used in most wind and water generating systems, have typical speeds of between 0 and 400 RPM. Point number three, the ratio between the drive and takeoff pulleys on the flywheel must be significantly different. Use either 4 to 1, 3 to 1, or at least 2 to 1 ratio between the drive and takeoff pulleys respectively. Point number four, the alternator must normally be able to withstand the load of the drive motor, plus any additional load intended. Use a 5 kV alternator with a 2 horsepower motor, for example. Similarly, use a 7 kV alternator with a 3 horsepower motor for best results. Finally, point number 5. Be patient. To achieve the correct pulley arrangement and effect, you may have to experiment with many pulley sizes, often improvising due to limited maker specifications. You would occasionally feel discouraged, but you must press on. My personal opinion is that you use a flywheel of fixed mass, and then focus on modifying the pulleys as required, reboring, resizing, or replacing as is necessary.